Silicone mold putty. In today's tutorial, we'll be covering the basic steps for making your own texture stamps and small, simple molds using our new silicone mold putty. Now, this particular putty comes as two different putties that are mixed together in a 1-to-1 ratio, and it cures to about a 35 to 40 Shore A. So it's a fairly firm rubber, which makes it ideal for making your own texture stamps or, again, small, simple molds. And the way this works is you scoop out equal parts of A and B. And you might have seen some of this on our Instagram page. If you don't follow us on Instagram, be sure to check us out. Instagram handle is at Bitty Mold Supply. When to measure out the two components, scoop out equal parts of A and B. And what I like to do is you can either weigh these out on a scale if you want to be really accurate, But this is forgiving enough. You can actually get two equal size little lumps, basically roll these out, and then I like to roll those by hand into two little balls and compare the sizes of them, make sure they're about the same size, and then knead those together. Now, the way this works, this has a working time of around 5 minutes at around 75 to 80 degrees. So you have plenty of time to mix this together. And I usually do this without gloves on. But if you do wear gloves, make sure you wear gloves that are not latex. Use either nitrile or vinyl gloves to mix this. And basically, you're just going to knead the two materials together until it forms one uniform purple color. So once you have that kneaded together, and you get rid of those little color striations like that you see there, then you're ready to make your mold. And what I do once that's all mixed up is, again, I roll that into a ball and then press that onto whatever surface that I want to mold or reproduce. Now, most surfaces will not require a release agent. Even this wicker basket that I got from our office did not require any kind of mold release. Now, surfaces like glass and some really clean metal surfaces might require a light spray of Eject-It 33. So if you're concerned about if you're molding something for a restoration project, make sure you take care to do a small test first to make sure everything releases okay before you do a surface you've never molded before. And also, this is a platinum silicone. So you want to be aware of any possible contaminants that might affect the curing of that putty. So again, when in doubt, mix up a small amount and press it onto that surface in a small insignificant area, and just make sure there's no contaminant that might keep that from curing. And as you see from these examples, this is a pretty easy product to use and apply. Basically, what I do is roll that up into a ball and then press that down, ideally from the center of the piece working outwards. So as you see here, I found a bolt that I wanted to reproduce on a street light. So I just rolled up a ball of that, pressed that down over the top, and then slowly work that down to the base. So ideally working out any air bubbles ahead of that. Now, for this particular piece, I was a little concerned since this is on a street light out in the general public, and I didn't want any of the local authorities here in Richardson to be concerned, so I put a little sign nearby just to make sure no one was concerned that this might be anything suspicious on this street light. Now, again, this particular product has a 5-minute working time and about a 30-minute demold. And faster than that, if you're working in here in Texas in a warm climate, Believe it or not, here in November, we had about almost an 80-degree day. So some of these pieces I was able to demold in about 25 minutes. And as you can see, it's very easy to release these pieces, even on that wicker basket texture. It came off beautifully. But again, just anytime you're working with a putty or any mold material like this over a surface that you're unfamiliar with, it's always a good idea to do a small test just to make sure, especially with restoration projects. The last thing you want to do is have this bond to a critical surface or have it leave an uncured silicone residue on a critical surface. Now, last but not least, we're going to demold that little bolt at the bottom of that street light. And you'll see that popped right off. Now, it's important to remember that silicone putty like this is more for its self-releasing abilities than its tear strength. I would not recommend this for a really large critical mold. This is more for the ability to take patterns and textures off of things in the wild, so to speak. You can keep a small kit of this on your person and mold headstones in graveyards or historical markers or what have you. It's a great mold material to have handy if you see an interesting texture that you want to incorporate in another project. Now here we're just going to mix up a small amount of resin and pour up that bolt. And here I'm just mixing up some TC-800 casting resin. This is just a very simple resin formula that is great for producing just hard white plastic parts. And this one cures in about 10 to 15 minutes at room temperature. So it's perfect for reproducing parts really fast like this. And what I usually do, the first copy that I pull out of a mold, especially a mold like this where it's pulled directly off a piece that's been rained on and had dust and dirt and who knows what else on it, your first part is probably not going to be too perfect because you're going to wind up cleaning all that gunk that was stuck to that original part. So here you see we've demold that part, and it has some of that dirt and grime that was on that original nut. And once we pop that out, now our mold is clean and the next part will come out perfect. Now, again, on those flat pieces, we can use those as texture stamps. As you see here, you can take a soft clays and press that in to get different textures that you want. But there might be some pieces where you actually want to use that as a mold to create a part with a little bit of dimension to it. So in that case, what you can do is set that stamp piece, that flat mold pad, as it were, on your workbench face up and knead some more putty and use that putty to create a dam around the outside, basically creating creating a flange around the part to hold in the casting material. And again, this is not a permanent mold arrangement, but more for allowing you to actually create a more serviceable cast part. So you could take that, sand it, clean it up, make it perfect, and then remold that for production. So here you see I basically just create a little snake of that silicone mold putty and work that around the edge of that stamp. And then I pinch that edge up to create a little wall or a little dam so that the resin won't run out. Because basically what I want to do is use this to create a little, about a quarter inch thick plate that'll have that water valve label on it. And just for fun here, once we've got that all in place, we're going to make another resin cast. And again, remember that our working time is around 5 minutes and demold time is around 25 to 30 minutes at around 75 to 80 degrees. So once everything is cured, we're going to very carefully pry that up. I just want to make sure it didn't stick to the table or the workbench before we proceed. And once I'm confident everything is holding together and we have a nice tidy mold, then we're ready to do our casting. Now I decided to have a little fun with this part since technically this is an old iron or cast iron cover here. I wanted to do something kind of similar to what it would look like before it rusted. So I brushed in some of our new black iridescent powder. This is a great powder for brushing into silicone molds to create weapon props. Has just a little bit of a metallic look to it, but overall it's more of a flat black. So it really replicates the look of like old gunmetal better than anything else. So once I brush that in, I'll blow out any excess with some compressed air. And then I'm ready to mix up some more resin and pour that into the mold. Now, anytime you're using a pigment powder brushed into the mold, I always like to move around the mold as I'm doing my pour. So here again, we've mixed up some TC-800 with some brown pigment, and I'm just going to pour that around and moving around so I don't pour in one spot and accidentally create kind of a bare area where I move some of that iridescent powder out of the way. Now the TC-800, for the uninitiated, that one has a working time of around 2 to 2.5 minutes and a demold time of around 10 to 15 minutes. So pretty fast cure. So again, very easy to produce a pattern from this. And real important to stress with silicone mold putty like this, real important to stress that this is by no means a production mold. Now, if you just needed a few parts, this would be good for that. But really, this is a way to get a pattern out of nature and onto your workbench. So then you could create more patterns and then make a more better quality production mold in your shop. And of course, as always, you can find all of the materials used in this video on our website at brickintheyard.com. I'll put all the product links in the video description. And if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe. I'll put a link to subscribe there on the screen on the left-hand side. And those of you who are new to resin casting and new to our channel, be sure to check out on the right-hand side. I'm going to put a link to one of our older videos explaining just kind of the nuts and bolts of basic resin casting. So be sure to check that out. That'll pop up on the right-hand side. And again, be sure to check the subscribe button and the little bell icon to the right of that. That way you get notifications anytime we create new content. Thanks again for watching, and if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe.